Hey, welcome, thanks for stopping by. It's time to learn with our friend Clive. So grab your brush, have a great time. And don't forget to click subscribe. Visit clive5art.co.uk.
Hello and welcome, and thank you very much for joining me once again in the studio today. Yes, I'm going to be painting away my stress today, like I do every day in Wales in the studio. It is lovely. And I've got a 20 by 24 inch canvas, which has basically had a light blue ground on it. And our ground is mixed, there's a little bit of acrylic paint mixed with some gesso, basically. So I'm just going to get my palette sorted out, and I'll just show you how I did that very quickly. And as you can see, after doing that, I prepared my canvas. Now, I'm actually going to be using my liquid clear. I'm going to be using that today. Now, you can do this without it, but liquid clear actually does make it a little bit easier. So I'm trying to showcase that today, and that is available on my website. So what I've done, I've got some Mars Black, and I've used some of this to thin that down, as you can see. So it's quite runny. It's around about a 20% there. Also, I'm going to be using some medium mix. There we are. That is also available on the website, www.clive5art.co.uk. And that stops underbinding of paint. In other words, your paint should not flake after you've used that. So you can thin it down as much as you like. And I'm also going to be showcasing my Mr. Bottle as well. Okay, and that's it really. So back to the canvas, and as you can see, as I said, it's a 20 by 24. It's been pre-gessoed, and without further ado, let's just get into this painting, I think. So I've got a one inch square there. Okay, it looks like a painting brush, but it's called a skyflow. There we are. And I like these because they're easier to hold. I like this type of brush, but any one inch basically will do this job. So I got a little bit of my liquid acrylic clear, and it's called acrylic clear, and it is actually got a little bit of a colour to it now, because I wanted to separate that away from the Bob Ross product, which is not basically compatible with this. So I've just put a little bit of that on my brush, and I got a little bit of that onto the palette. I'm going to get some of this phthalo blue there, just drag some phthalo blue across, and some Mars Black. There we are. And I'm just going to mix that together. I'm going to get some of this thinner Mars Black as well. There we go. And I'm just going to pick up a touch of white then on the tip of my brush. And now I'm just going to go into the sky area. And as you can see, this is quite nice and smooth. It flows really well, actually. So we need it quite dark up in the top. So we're just going to do the top first, and using the brush in this motion. Now you might see there's a little bit of glare on the canvases. I've moved the cameras to try and compensate for that, but it's inevitable that this is going to happen with something like this, because the liquid clear will stay wet for quite a while. So if there is a bit of glare, I'll try and edit that out as much as I can during the editing. And also, while I'm saying that, I'm picking up some white. As I'm saying that, I've got a little bit of background noise as well, because it's quite warm in the studio today. And I've just added a little bit of white into the sky. And this is the first stage. Let's just get this sky in a bottom area in place. You can hear a little molly in the background there. So back into that colour, a little bit of white. There you go. And then just bring that down like this. And just cover in the canvas quite nicely. So there is a bit of background noise going on, but as I said, I will try and limit it as much as I possibly can. There we go. I want this to be like a night sky type of feeling. I'm just going straight into some titanium white now. That's just plain titanium white with no thinner no water, no medium mix. There's no liquid clear in that at all. I'm going to get a little bit of burnt umber just on the tip of my brush. Just on the tip of my brush. Not a lot. There's not a lot of paint there. I'm just going to put a bit of burnt umber into this sky like that. Just to put a little bit of a different feel to this sky. Now I did a Northern Lights. I'm just going to pick up a little bit of medium mix, just the smallest amount on my brush. Picking up some of this paint again, a little bit of that thinned Mars black, a bit of white, a bit more white now, a bit more white. That's not enough white, so I just pick up a bit more white. If it's not enough, you can blend this in. This will stay workable for about 40 minutes. It should stay wet for about 40 minutes, depending on the environment you're actually in. So I want it a bit lighter. The horizon line is going to be roughly there. So we didn't put that in, but it doesn't matter. So we're just putting that in by eye. And we're just going to put a few nice shapes in like that. And let's get a bit more of this phthalo blue and black. And a little bit more white on my brush. And then just darken this area up a little bit more. And I did a Northern Lights painting the other week, and a couple of weeks ago actually, and I did say that was more of an example painting, and it was designed in such a way that would encourage you to, one, to view it, and two, to actually have a little try. And it was designed specifically for somebody that's never painted before, and it wasn't as good as I wanted it to be. But it got my point across, and that's all that counts. I got a little bit of burnt umber back on my brush. Just bringing a bit of that burnt umber back in. Just to make that sky look as if it's, I don't know, a bit of a thundery sky there. Picking up a little bit of white on my brush again. And bringing that area in like this. And practice. If this is a little bit big, if this canvas is a little bit big for you, what I suggest you do is practice this technique on a smaller canvas. If you feel a little bit overwhelmed by the size of the canvas, then I suggest you practice a little bit on a smaller canvas. There we go. So we've got a nice looking type of sky coming in there now. And let's just darken that area up a little bit by there. There you go. Darken that area up a little bit, but then I'm just going to wash my brush. If you notice during that process, I never actually washed my brush once. I was just using all those tones there that in the paint. So you can quite easily do that. And once your brush is washed, take the excess off, and then if you very quickly, you can just very, very lightly, there's no pressure, very, very pressure, just tickle the hairs on the back of your hand. There we go, and that's the pressure you were looking for. Tickle the hairs on the back of your hand, and let's get this sky all nice and merged. And oh, it's lovely. That is lovely, 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 lovely. Now this is going to be a water area, so I'm going to bring in a little bit of white. I'm going to pick up a little bit of this liquid clear. There you go, just to thin that paint down, and I'm just going to put in a little bit of white across. Now you can put the liquid clear on first and then add the white to it, or you can add the liquid clear to the white. Now the reason I'm showcasing the liquid clear today is because I got a lot of people out there now that has actually purchased this, and a lot of people inquiring about it. So I think it's important that I show you how to use it. But if you want to use a little bit of water, then you can still do this technique, but you're going to have to work a lot quicker. So I'm just adding the white in there like that. There you go. And that's all we're doing, is working on our background at the moment. Again, picking up a little bit of this black, a little bit of this burnt umber mix. Not a lot of burnt umber, not a lot. And then you can blend that in. Keeping that back as light as you can. Bringing that down like this, merge it in together. The other thing you can do, if you wanted to, and you've got to be careful, as that's starting to dry, it will lift. So when you use your mister bottle, use your mister bottle, but point it slightly downwards. Don't lift it up like that, because it's going to splat and you're going to have little orange peel marks. Just put a little bit of moisture. Just put a little bit of moisture onto your canvas like that. And that's going to allow the paint, that's going to allow your paint to slip and slide a lot easier than trying to go straight onto a dry area. So we're going to pick up this blue now. We want a bit more blue than black in this area. And we're just developing this lovely, lovely colour like this. There we go. Just bring that in like that. And again, a little bit of white, a little bit of white. And let's just do this area over here. And just keep it moving. Just keep it moving. Don't go back into the sky. Whatever you do now, do not go back into that sky, because you're going to start to lift paint. The surface tension of that paint is already started to dry. So if you go into there now, it's going to start to come away, because acrylic paint dries by forming the skin. And when the skin forms, it doesn't necessarily mean that the underlying layer of that paint is dry. It just means that the top part of the paint is dry, and that's where we get problems with paint lift and things like that. So that's important to remember. So adding a bit more black, a bit more blue. I want this a little bit darker down this area now. There you go. So important to remember that acrylics dry by forming the skin, and when the skin forms and the paint feels dry, it is not necessarily dry straight through to the canvas. In fact, it can take up to 2 weeks for that paint to dry the way you want it to dry. So you should always wait 2 weeks, at minimum of 2 weeks. If you go into varnish a painting, then I would wait at least 2 weeks for that. There you go. So I want a little bit more colour into this water. I want it a little bit greyer there. Maintaining that white band, that's important. But this phthalo blue, which is just basic phthalo blue, it's not red shade or green shade, it's all basics. A bit, little bit more of this liquid clear, just to get your paint to run and blend and smooth in like this. And this is a fantastic medium that's been developed by myself and my friend to work in conjunction with this. And we use it as well for the Bob Ross techniques, and which are very popular. And the links will be, there will be a link in the iCards above if you want to have a look at that. So we're just about coming to the end of this first stage of the painting. And as I said, I want it quite dark down here. There we go. And we're going to maintain that as much as we can. We're going to try and keep that wet, as he says, as he picks up some white by mistake. Doesn't matter. Let's get back into some of this phthalo blue, and let's just blend that in like this. So you don't need a lot. I emphasize that. In fact, if you put that straight onto a canvas, as you've seen me do with some of the Bob Ross techniques, I always take some off with a tissue paper. So it's important that you don't overdo. The more that you add to your paint, the longer it's going to take to dry, basically, because it's going to thin down. And you don't want that to happen if you can help it. But you want to maintain, obviously, a time scale where your paint is going to dry. They can see the sky starting to dry there now. And you can force dry this with a hairdryer as well. So just put that in. I'm going to get some burnt umber now. Burnt umber straight on my brush. And I'm just going to put a bit of burnt umber straight on the bottom, like this. Looks strange, I know it looks strange. But that could represent some sand, couldn't it? If you think about it, sand is our colour, and this is going to be night sky. So let's just put a little bit of colour into the base of this painting. We can go up a little bit there, it doesn't matter. And of course, there's quite a few elements in this painting, so this might take an hour, it might take 2 hours. I am not too sure how long this is going to actually take. And that is the first section completed. As you can see, we've got the sky in place. We've got a little bit of color in there, like as if there's a little bit of a storm cloud. We got some lovely blue colors and some tones. We got a nice white band of an area there that's going to show distance, and we've put a little bit of burnt umber down here to represent some sort of a sand or ground mass, because we're going to have water in this. So we're going to work out that, and that's the next thing we've got to work out. So I'm going to dry this with a hairdryer now, and when I come back, we will be starting on another stage. Hey, I'm having fun. Now, I recommend that you give that just a minute or two to cool down, because what's going to happen is, because that canvas is being hit with a hairdryer and it's quite hot, if you put paint on top of that now, it's just going to go and it's going to dry on off on you. So might not be a lot, but it's going to be enough to cause you a problem. There we go. So just give that a minute or so. And as we do that, let's go into, I've got a 1-inch, a 1-inch short flat. I've got a 1-inch short flat. There you go. And I'm going to make a wash. Now, it's important that I do this because I want this to create some sort of an atmosphere. And if you've never tried, then again, practice on a smaller canvas. I'm getting some of my medium mix formula, which is the underbinding formula to stop underbinding the paint. And I get some phyllo blue. There you go. And I'm going to make a very, very thin, watery type of mix. And this is fantastic. You can use this medium mix if you wanted to make watercolors. But without confusing the issue, you don't need to worry about how thin your acrylic paints are on paper, because paper will absorb the paint. You're looking for something that's got a bit of resistance, like canvas will peel, and masonette and hardboard and things like that. But if you're actually painting directly onto paper, then it doesn't matter how thin you make this paint. So I've loaded that 1-inch brush, and I'm going to very lightly go over the old canvas now, like as if I'm varnishing it. But this is called a glaze or a wash. I like to call them washes. But they're a glaze of colour, basically. That's all they are. And that's just going to cool down. That's going to cool down the whole sky. And it's going to fill up any imperfections that you've got. So you see you've got a little bit of canvas showing through where you haven't quite covered it with the brush. You've got a little bit of canvas showing through, a couple of little white spots. Then this is a great fix. This really is a great fix for that. But it also gives it a nice little of a luster. It also does a nice luster. Now, let's just get a little bit more paint. I don't want it too strong, because phyllo blue is a very strong colour. So don't overdo phyllo blue, because it can ruin your painting in a heartbeat. It really can. Ruin your painting in a heartbeat. Very, very careful. And just take your time. There's no rush. We're not in a race to do paintings. In fact, the longer it takes you to do a painting, the better effects you're going to get from them. Unfortunately, I'm in front of a camera, and we've got a certain time to try and get these things completed in order for you to be able to accomplish them. And that's my mission, is to make things as easy as I can, even though sometimes They're hard. I got to try and make them as easy as I can. I want you to have a go, and that is important. My mission in life is to get you painting if you haven't already painted, and to keep you painting if you are painting. And we all lose our mojo sometimes. And sometimes I come in the studio and I turn the cameras on and I look at the canvas and I think, I can't do this tonight. I'm not in the mood. And you need to be in a certain frame of mind sometimes to able to do something. It's easier once you've started a painting, but not so easy to get a painting started sometimes, because your concentration, your inspiration, you get inspiration lapses and things like this. And you know, it's very important that you remember all that. If you don't feel like painting, don't paint. Because you'll only get upset. You'll only get upset with the results, and that's not what painting is about. Painting is about therapy, about art therapy. It's about feeling good for yourself. It's about getting all that enjoyment as well, and just enjoying this time with yourself, or just enjoying this time with your favorite YouTube artist, or you know, it's just letting your husband watch you or your wife watch you painting and just enjoying the process. And that's what art is all about. My art is all about. That is my philosophy on painting. There we are. And we go very, very lightly. Very, very lightly. Just very, very lightly across then. Like that. And that stage is now complete. So we got to dry that once more. And this is why I like acrylics. Because you couldn't do this with oils unless you waited for that to dry like 6 or 7 weeks before you did that. This is why I like acrylics, because we can force dry them with hair dryers. There we go. I don't know where the end of my hair dryer has gone, but it doesn't matter. Found the end of my hair dryer. It was on the floor. There we go. Now what we need to do now is to put a mask on you. And there we are. I got a little bit of my parchment paper or greaseproof paper or baking paper. You could use newsprint. You can use anything that you want, as far as that is concerned, to act as a mask. And what I suggest you do is get a little bit of, there we go, just get a little bit of masking tape. And this is decorator's tape. And let's just put a mask on our, okay, that doesn't have to be perfect. I just, that will do, I think. So all we need to do is protect the bottom of the painting. That was the only reason I did that. And now I've got a little brush here. Here we go. Let's try and find that one now. Organization? No, not in Clive Studio. I've got one of them brushes. There we are. Look. Little fan brush. I don't know if you can see that little fan brush. That's the one I chopped and chopped. And you've seen me doing this before, because I'm going to put stars on. Yes, I am. And again, a little bit of liquid clear. Just go into that white like this. Load that brush up. And be very careful. You don't overload it too much. And all I want you to do then is grab your brush like that in your hand. And then pull towards you. Pull toward, not away from you, because you're going to get covered in paint. Pull towards you. Just to get some stars. Don't forget there's going to be more stars at the bottom area than the top, because they're further away and they're going to look as if they're closer together. There's going to be a lot more stars down there than what there is up there. There we go. So just put a few more stars down the bottom and a few less up the top. There you go. Simple. Simple, simple, simple. Some of these will be just disappeared into the painting. But we know they're there. We know they're there. And that's all it is. Look, easy. Put that in the bucket of water. And let's just get a little detailing brush. There we go. I'm just picking up any detail brush. This happens to be a 4.0, which is a small one. And I'm just going to pick up just a little bit of white paint here and there. And just make a few bigger ones. Just to catch the eye a little bit. There we are. It could be galaxies, couldn't they? It could be. Or you could just put a little one there, and maybe just a one there. It could be a sky that's full of shooting stars. You know? We put three because it's an odd number. Odd numbers work, they do. And well, I'm just going to clean my brushes. I'm going to remove this mask, keeping the parchment paper for the wet palette. There we go. So we've got a sky now that has got some stars in it. It certainly has. Now, I'm not going to put the nebula in yet, because the next stage is to work on the... I got an idea to put a mountain range in. So we're going to be working on some mountains on the next stage. But I'm going to dry that off again with a hairdryer and wash my brushes. And I think I can carry on using the colours I've got so far. So this is pretty good for the colours we've got. Very limited palette. Fantastic, brilliant and vibrant painting. Okay, I've dried that off. Now I'm going to look at some mountain ranges, and what I'm going to be using for that is a couple of short flats. There we are. These are number half inch short flats. There we go. Half inch short flats. And I'm going to be using one of my blenders. You can buy one of these blenders off the website, www.clive5art.co.uk, along with a liquid clear, medium mix and the fine mist bottle. But I've also got a little tiny one as well. I haven't got these available at the moment because I can't get my hands on them. Well, I got to get some made actually, but there we go. But for the moment, they're okay. They will suffice. So I'm looking at the... I'm picking up a bit of this very thin black there. I'm going back into this blue. There you go. And I'm making a nice dark color. I'm going to actually put a little bit of brown, a bit of burnt umber with that. And now the sun is beating down on top of the conservatory roof, and I'm starting to sweat. Wow. It is hot today. It is. Okay, I'm not going to tell you what month this is, because time is relative on YouTube, and it doesn't really matter anyway. Okay, so I'm looking at a reference photograph. I've got of some mountains, and I'm just going to go, like that. Commit yourself to a mountain shape. Doesn't have to be anything in particular. Just commit yourself to something like a mountain shape. But it's the edge of that shape there that you want to think about. Let's put a little bit more of a peak there like that. And then just drag that down like this. Okay. Roughly there. Yes, that should be okay. Now the other brush I've got, and I pick up some white. There you go. There's a bit of that white, a little bit of blue, a little bit of white in there. Doesn't really matter. Doesn't matter. And then just go in that. And just bleed the bottom of that off like that. Just get a little bit more of that Prussian blue. And then just merge all that together like that. Now this could be a lake, or it could be the sea, or it could be anything really if you think about it. Just merge that together like that. It could be the lake, it could be the sea, it could be anything. I don't know what this is. This is just something I was thinking of doing. And like most things, if I'd seen this somewhere else before, I wouldn't be surprised, because I love looking at different paintings and things. But this is going to be a fantastic painting today, I think. I'm just going to add a little bit more blue to that one, because I want to blue that off. I want to blue that off. It's always going to be a little bit more silhouette-y. So the bluer it is, the more distant it's going to look. And we just add a smallest touch of white. In fact, taking some off. Just to lighten that down. Like that. Just to lighten it down. But you are going to have a little bit more of a silhouette type of look about and feel about that mountain anyway. So back into this dark colour. I want this, like as if there's one coming in front of that now. Like this. And I want that to come up. I want that to come down. Using the edge of the brush. Using the side of the brush to its advantage. There we go. Look how I'm using the brush. Look how I'm holding the brush. That's important. And I'm holding the brush like this. I'm holding the brush like that. And I'm just using, and I'm dragging the brush. And that's one of the things that makes life a lot easier. You get different patterns and things. And now I got an idea for something to be used. So I'm not going to be too worried about the mountains over this side. But I'm just going to put some in anyway, just for the sake of it, I think. And I'm just going to drag them in like that. It could be just a mountain range or a bit of a footy hill or something like that. There you go. And let's just tidy that up there. Again, I'm going to pick up a bit of this blue, a little bit of white. And I'm just going to come in very lightly. Too much blue, not enough white. There we are. Just merge that in. Let's merge that in now and bring that into the bottom of these mountains. Get that grey pulling down. A little bit more moisture. Get a little bit of liquid clear into that paint, because we want it to stay wet, and we want it to move about, and we want it to blend. And water evaporates quicker than this medium. So that way it's going to stay wetter for longer. That's all it is. And it's an acrylic based resin that I'm using with a couple of other things thrown in the mix, just to make that medium work the way I want it to. Now you can see that by doing this, I'm developing a little bit of mist there on those mountain Bases, there we go. Mountain bases. Do mountains have bases? I don't know. Who knows? I don't know. Doesn't matter anyway. You know what I mean. There we go. So you can see that one's a bit bluer and this one's a lot darker. So hopefully you could see that one's actually right way in the background there. It could be a good few miles away, that one. Let's just get another range there. There you go. Let's put darker. It's dark now. That doesn't look right, does it? Doesn't. It looks a bit weird, that one. Looks more of a footy hill. Yeah, I can come in front of that one. There you go. Not that I'm worried about that one, I'm not. Okay, so I'm going to wash those brushes. I'm going to dry this again with a hairdryer. Give it a second to cool off. Yes, it's important that we do that. Now, we've got a little bit of fantastic... We've got a fantastic mountain range there, haven't we? We have. So I've just picked up a little filbert, which is a number 8 filbert brush, is that one. A number 8 filbert brush. Well worn. It's not so sharp on the edge, but it doesn't matter. I quite like my little filbert brushes. I'm going to pick up a little bit of white, and I'm going to bring that into that colour there. We've got a bit of black, we've got a bit of burnt umber, we've got a bit of Phthalo blue. Taking the excess off my brush. Now, I've got to think, light source, where is my light coming from? Well, it doesn't matter too much in the background there, but I'm thinking maybe I have a little bit of light catching this edge here. I'm just dragging it down like this. I'll do a lesson on mountains and show you how to do mountains. The Bob Ross way with acrylics. That's going to be fun. Trust me. My friend Jason Bowen is a certified Bob Ross teacher, in fact. Yes. And I quite like Jason's paintings, especially his mountain ranges and stuff. And he's been doing fantastic work with the Nebula one as well. And I like doing this because I can get away with a lot. Because if I make this too light, then I can just go over it with a little bit of a wash, like we did with the sky. But we can still get the effects that we're looking for. We can. And let's just put a little bit of light over there, like that. As if something's catching there. There you go. Now the light, I want the light to catch this side more than that side. There you go. But you're going to have a little bit of light just touching here and there like that. Just a bit of light. And just very lightly dragging. Just very lightly dragging down some shapes like that. Practice on a small canvas. If you're not confident to try this, practice on a smaller canvas. Now, I'm going to get a bit of blue. A bit of that phthalo blue, a bit of that burnt umber together. Get a bit of phthalo blue and a bit of burnt umber. I'm just going to darken down the background, put a bit of shadow in these mountains, like that. Just put a little bit of shadow in here and there, and there and here, and everywhere that you think it's going to justify just a little bit of shadow in. There you go, even on there, look. Put a little bit of shadow in there if you wanted to. We could bring this mass of land out now if we wanted to. We could bring that, we could extend that with this little brush, just using that little filbert brush. Just using, don't forget, we can adjust this horizon line if we wanted to. That's not a problem. We can add a little bit more white and a bit of blue. We can't do that with oils. You can do it with acrylics. You can. Are we going to make this a lake or are we going to make this a sea? I don't know. These are quite way, way in the distance. Let's just darken that down a bit like that. Just darken it down a touch. In fact, I quite like that a little bit darker than this, so I might do that, in fact. And let's give it a try. If you think of something and you think, maybe that's not exactly what I planned, but let's see how it looks. So get a little bit of this medium mix formula, a little bit of the phthalo blue, a little bit of burnt umber together, and let's see what happens if we just darken this down a touch, because we can always lighten it, as I've said before, and is experimenting. Don't worry about changing your direction or changing your plans. I talked about mojo and things. It's important that you think about, you know, that it does that work? Does it work? Try it. You can always paint over it. You can always dry it. You can always dry the acrylics with a hairdryer and paint over it. With oil painting, you've got to scrape it off and start again. But with acrylics, you haven't got that problem. So let's just darken down this a little bit more. Let's get a bit more blue now there into that brush rather than the... And this is a very thin colour. Very thin colour. There we go. Just put a bit more blue than brown. A bit more blue than brown. And then just bring in that across like this. Very, very lightly, very, very thinly. Just washing that colour into the background like that. Need a bit more thinner, then use a little bit of medium mix, or you can use a little bit of liquid clear. Liquid clear is good, but as you know, it'll stay wet longer. So if I put a little bit of liquid clear there now, I can come back in about 10 minutes and that's still going to be wet. Maybe not today in this studio, because it's like an oven today. It really is. We've got a nice colour there, I think. Nice colour there, I think. There we go, a nice colour. What we can do now is dry that off again with a hairdryer, and then we'll knock those mountain range back a touch. Just give it a little bit of a foggy, misty look of effect. Foggy, looky, misty effect. Ideally, you should be about 6 inches away from the canvas, but because I want to get it done quickly, I'm actually forcing it to dry rather than encouraging it to dry. So there we go. That'll do for now. Now I'm going to pick up my 1 inch short flat again. There you go, my 1 inch short flat. You can use a little bit of zinc mixing white if you've got zinc mixing white. That's what I tend to use for this technique. As you know, I'm going to do a little bit of a wash. I don't want a lot. You can use some titanium white if that's all you've got. Just use plain water or my medium mix, which is available on the website, as I've said, for this. And that way, then it'll work just as good. But with the titanium white, use very little paint. Use very little paint because it's very opaque, and this relies on it not being opaque, basically. And I'm just going to very lightly just put a bit of a glaze in the sky. Look, flicking this up like that, so it looks as if there's a little bit of light behind them mountains, and it's just zinging up into the sky there. Okay. You might be wondering, Clive, where's these northern lights you've been talking about? Well, they're going to be appearing quite shortly, I think. But let's just get this in place first, in situ, as they say. Let's just concentrate on this. And let's knock them back just a little bit more. Just add a little bit more of that zinc mixing white to your brush. Not a lot. Don't overdo this. You can spoil it very, very quickly by doing this. So you've got to be confident. I got confidence in you. I got more confidence in you than you've got in yourself. I know you can do this. I know you can accomplish this. You just got to believe you can. Get in the 1 inch blending brush again, which are available on the website, and then very lightly. Oh, this, it, look, tickle in the back of your hand like a yes, tickle in the back of your hand. I'm just using the brush like this, very, very lightly. It's hardly touching in spots, actually. It's hardly touching. There you go. But is that enough to knock those mountains back? Maybe. I think so. I think that should be okay. Yes, I think that will be fine. Okay, so I'm going to wash my brushes. I'm going to let that dry naturally. I'm going to open the studio door. I'm going to make myself a cup of tea, and I shall be back. And I'm back. Quick as that. So I want to think about water now. Water, 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 water. I don't know whether they bring in. I think, okay, let's just wing it, as they say. So I got to get myself positioned in front of the canvas as best I can, because I don't want to obscure any cameras, but then again, I need to get to the canvas. So I've got my trusty half-inch short flat. That's that one. And I'm just going to put a little bit of liquid clear there, like that. Take off the excess off my brush. And I think, I'm going to go into a little bit of this dark grey. Let's bring a little bit of that white to that. Let's just, using the same colours, I'm taking the excess off onto a little bit of kitchen roll, and then starting with this motion, I'm just going to put in some very, very light, subtle, dark marks, I guess, just to represent some shadow in the water. And you take your time with this. Don't cover up all that blue. That's the key. It's not to cover up all our blue. I think I'll zoom one of the cameras in just to show you. I think I'll take this one. I just zoomed one camera in. So very lightly, like this. On a lark, rock your brush like this. That's exaggerated. It's a half moon. But don't cover up all the blue, all the white areas, you know, you've got them there. You need to keep some of that in place. These are just shadow marks that we're putting in. You could do it opposite. You could put a darker base down and then put the white on top. And if you've seen the way Bob Ross does it, he's put a liquid clear down and then he goes in with some white. And you can do it with this. You can do that. If you wanted to, you can do that. Now, as they come further towards you, you want to make them just slightly bigger with a little bit more of an arc, like this. And all we're doing is putting shadow in the water. And this is a lake, I expect. In my head, it's a lake. In my head, it's a lake. It is. Don't be regimental. Leave it loose. If you put a couple of bigger, thicker bits in there, don't worry. Let it ride. It'll all settle down. There we go. It will all settle down. I'm just adding a little bit more white to that colour. Getting a bit more kitchen roll. Because this is darker there than what it was there. So I wanted to put a bit of light in. So I'm going to bring a bit of light in now. A little bit too much paint on my brush. But if we can put that in now. Like that. Just like, as if the light is just catching that section of the water. There you go. It's not light enough. Just play with the colour until you get it right. So the light could be catching and zinging down there. Or not. It's entirely up to you how we want to play this. But just all you could do is just put some lines in. Now, instead of putting shadows in, I'm just catching the highlights of the waves because it's light to this side. And a bit choppier there because I'm sitting on a really strange angle. I'm trying to get that rock in motion without getting my big head in the camera. I'll have to move my seat, I think. Bit choppier. It's a bring some of my highlights in. Let's bring some of them highlights down over here. Just like as if it's little ripples or even foam patterns. It could be the sea, it could be the ocean, it could be anything really, couldn't it? It doesn't really matter. All we want to do is give it a little look of water. In fact, I think we'll do maybe an estuary or something, or the sea, or I don't know. It doesn't matter. Let's just make some, let's make it up as we go along here. There we go. It's a little bit choppier here. And don't forget, if you've gone a little bit mad with a white like this, we can always put a little wash over it like we did with the sky. So don't worry, never worry about making mistakes like this, especially with acrylics, because if you've put this on a little bit light in places, then we can always put a wash over it. I'm going to put something in this corner. I'm just going to bring this down just a little bit more, you allow, like this. It's choppy, but it's not too choppy, if you understand what I mean. Today this is just a little bit of a swell in the water. There's a little bit of a choppiness there, but not a lot. There we are. Let's go back into some of that darker colour now. And let's just put a bit of shadow just under those areas like that. There you go. Always take a little bit off your brush. It's easier if you take a little bit off your brush. Just putting a bit of shadow back in. Just under these waves. Like that. How are we looking? Okay, what I want to do now is get some of this white. And I want to just... And this is very similar to what we're going to do in the sky later on. Just drag a little brush. Drag your brush down. Like that. Pull it up. All across. A bit more white in there. And let's bring a foam pattern down. Wet your brush, damp brush, before that dries. Just pull that in, as if it's a bit of a water coming in there, like that. In fact, let's get a little bit of liquid clear on my brush. Yeah, that would be better. Let's put another foam pattern there. If you get another short flat, and I got one here somewhere, I know where I put it. There it is. Which is a little bit damp. And then we can do, there's no paint on this brush, it's just damp, and it's just lifting that liquid clear. It's exactly what we can do with the sky. Just bring that in like that. Lift it. Blend it. Get a bit of colour. Just get a bit of shadow on there. Lift it, blend it, lift it, and blend it. Just gives that look at its water coming forward. And let's just do this section over here now. I'm not too worried about you because I got ideas for this, so. All you do is lift and blend. Okay, so what we could do now is get some liquid clear on a 1-inch brush, take the excess off, put that directly onto the canvas, a little bit of liquid clear, not a lot, directly onto the canvas like this. Let's just get a little bit of this white on the same brush and then just pull down. Take the excess off, dry your brush very quickly on some kitchen roll and then just pull across. It'll look wet. There we are. Can we see that? I think we can see that. I hope we can. So I'll do that again. A little bit of white, a little bit of blue, a little bit of black, all the same colours. Pull down. Wiping your brush dry on some kitchen roll and then lightly pull across. Put a couple of lines in like that. That's going to look wet. Got a bit of reflection going on. So let's get a bit of this darker colour now again on our brush. And let's just put some darker colour in there. And maybe we'll put a little bit more white. I think we'll go for a little bit of white now. A bit more white. And again, up. If that's gone a little bit dry, just get a little bit of liquid clear on your brush. That's going to reactivate that paint enough for you just to blend it through like this. Get a little bit of dark just underneath. Get a little bit of dark. It looks like a little bit of a swell coming on in there then. Go. What you could do then is you could get a strip line and brush if you wanted to, and we can put a lot more detail in there. If you want to get some of this nice dark color, make sure that you use your liquid clear or water to thin your brush down and thin your paint down like ink, and then just allow your brush to make all these little marks like this. Where's your blending brush? Get your blending brush. I went a bit crazy. I go a bit crazy sometimes. That's better. Just put a few little lines in like that. Don't go crazy like me. I'm just rushing this a little bit. Maybe a few foamy patterns in as well, just to make it look and that's all we need to do really, don't we? Get a blending brush very lightly then and just knock those back like that. How does that look? Looks pretty good. Anyway, that's all I need to do with that as far as I'm concerned at the moment. You can play around with that water as much as you want. If you wanted to put a wash on, then I would suggest you go back into your 1-inch short flat again and pick up a bit of this blue colour over there, thin it down with a little bit of water, a little bit of liquid clear. I would say suggest water very, very thinly, and then let's just put a little bit of colour back on to the canvas like this, going over that blue, or over that white, sorry, with some blue. There you go, just to tone that down like that. You could bring a bit more burnt umber down there. That's still wet there. We want to show a bit of sand down here, so we put a bit of colour in, and what we do then is we've got a little bit of white, didn't we, and then we went down just like that, and then we went very, very lightly across, just to make it look as if it's a little bit of reflection in the water on the sand, make it look wet basically. Making it look wet. Okay, so you put as much detail in that as you want, and you put as many breakers in, or you can have it flat, or you can have whatever you want on there. So that's all I would suggest you do. Now the next stage is I'm going to dry that off, and let's put some nebulas in. I think that's the next job. Actually, I'll tell you what you could do before we did that. I'm running ahead of myself. Get your detailing brush, get a little bit of this black colour, and you could just put a little line, shadow line, just underneath this breaker, like that. Put a few little wiggly bits in, like that. Let's just put a few. Just water lines or whatever. There. Getting our blending brush now. Very lightly. Very, very lightly. Over that. Like that. Get across like that, and you can always go down as well. You can pull it down that way if you want to as well, and then very lightly across, just to give it that essence of wet. There you go. I'll do for now. I'm happy with that. Okay, so that should dry off naturally on its own now. Whoops, just dropped a bit of tissue paper. Where's my bin? And there it is. Okay, let's have a look at the nebula now. I did this a couple of weeks ago on an example painting, and I was hoping that enough of you would have a go at that and practice, and I think you have, because over 20,000 of you have watched it so far. So I'm hoping that, you know, you'll all watch this as well now. So that's what I encourage you to do anyway. Okay, so let's get a little bit of white, and let's make a lovely blue greyish color there, like that. There we go, a nice blue color. I'm going to add a little bit more phthalo blue to this side. There we are. I'm going to put a bit of that but there, quite thin paint. I'm going to add a touch of yellow. I just added some yellow to my palette. Yes, a little bit of medium yellow, just to put a little bit of green in there, like that. I want to sparkle that up just a touch with a little bit of green, because my sky is going to have a little bit of green in it, maybe a little bit of yellow as well. I haven't decided exactly what yet. Right, liquid clear, that's the key. Liquid clear on your brush. Liquid clear on your brush. Let's put that up there so you can see it. Dipping my brush into liquid clear, taking the excess of the liquid clear off, going straight into some paint. Again, taking some off. I'm going to start in this section now, and I'm just going to go down like this. Just make a little ribbon. Just make a little ribbon like that, going down into the horizon. Get your other little short flat, which is damp now, it should be, and then just pull up the paint like that. That's actually dried a little bit quicker than I wanted it to. Let's put a little bit more ribbon in on this. Pull up, that's better. Pull up like that. Get a little bit of white on your brush, just lighten that colour a touch. Just put a little bit of you, a little bit there, coming down a touch. Again, getting into this dry brush and pulling that straight up like that, nice and subtle. Can you see that little ribbon? Nice and subtle. And we can make it a little bit lighter if you wanted to. We could put another, just go straight over your ribbon like that, and then straight up like that. That's a little bit white, but it's okay, we can add a little bit of blue to that later on. Okay, let's get a little bit more blue, a little bit more blue, a little bit more white. Let's just lighten this blue up a bit. There we go. And now we want to put another ribbon just coming off that one, maybe just like that. Again, before it dries, lift up with our brush like that. There you go. We'll put it down a little bit if we wanted to get that glow. A little bit more white, a little bit more white, just to emphasize that color. Lovely, nice. Okay, let's get a bit of green in there. Let's mix this green now. Let's get some more white. Let's get some yellow. Let's just get this a nice green color. I'm running out of white. I have to put some more white on my palette. I don't want it too bright. I want it quite subdued. Quite subdued. And I shouldn't put a brush in your mouth, but I am, because I got nowhere else to put it. So I want another one ribbon. Very loosely. And that's enough. Change your brush. Lift up. Just get that glow in the sky. Let's get a little bit more white. Let's just sparkle that up. Just in certain areas, look. Just on certain points. And then Rifka. Nice and subtly. Let's put a little bit of white on my palette because we need to sparkle things up a little bit. And let's go back into some blue. I'm using all the same colours because I want this to be roughly the same throughout. I'm trying to use the same tones of paint if I can, and I want to put another bigger ribbon, a little bit thicker now. And I'm just picking up a little bit of liquid clear just on the tip of my brush, and I'm going to rub that in to that paint because it is drying very quickly because I got the studio door shut again and it's really hot in here, and I'm just lifting up like that. Okay, you can increase those flecks if you want to by just using the very edge of your brush like that. Gaseous clouds they are, gas, it's just gas, argon gas and stuff like that in the atmosphere. All different gases give off different colours, they really do, and that's all it is, I believe it's, that's what it is anyway. Just bring a little bit of colour in. I'm not too sure on the names of the gases, I know argon is one of them. Let's just bring a little bit of this sparkle that up. That's nice. Looking good. Looking good. Washing the brush. And I'm going to start some more fresh paint over there. I'm going to bring some liquid clear to that. Some white. And now I want to put another gaseous cloud in. Lovely jubbly. Lovely jubbly. Bring a bit of extra colour in. Let's get some blue. Some yellow, some white, make a nice white. Let's put some liquid clear in with that, mixing it up, because we're going to have another ribbon coming down. I'm mixing in with that one. Brush. Sparkly, sparkly, sparkly. Let's just get a looking pretty good, I think so. I'm happy with that so far. I'm getting a little bit more blue into this color, and I think I think I'm going to have just a thick one there like that. Just disappearing. There's no shape to these things. Just get a little bit of white. Just a little bit of white. Just down that edge there. And just follow that around there like that. I need a little bit of concentration because it does need it. It does warrant concentration, this does. It really does. I would say on a difficulty rating, it's like a cloud because you've got a tendency of overdoing it. Tendency of overdoing it a bit. Let's get a bit of colour in there now. I'm not too sure on the colours actually. I think there's oranges and yellows and reds and all that type of stuff in this sky, but I think as far as just checking the cameras, I think that looks pretty good so far. I think it does, and I'm going to emphasise a few more of these. There, if you wanted to do that, because the picture I was going off has got quite a lot of long stringy things coming off it. Like that. I think for the moment, let's just get a little bit more yellow on my brush there. Let's just put a little bit of brightness there. That's better. Let's balance it out a little bit on it. Okay. What do we think? I think that's looking pretty good. Okay, next stage. We've got the northern lights in, and I think we're gonna be ready for the next stage now. We could get a little strip lining brush, and let's see if I can do this with a strip lining brush. I'll just put a bit of liquid clear on that, and I just wanted to. Emphasize there you go. Sometimes it works, sometimes things work, sometimes they don't, so but it's always worth a try. I don't know if I like that actually, but it doesn't matter. It just gives it a little bit more of a there's no right or wrong way of doing something like this. Just whatever works, I think. And that'll do me anyway. So I'm going to dry that off and we're going to go to the next stage. Because I've just had a brilliant idea. Yes, a little bit mad, a little bit insane. But that's what Clive does in his studio. So I'm going to dry this off, shoot over my drawing desk and do something very special. And let's take this one step further. There we are. I'm just putting an outline on. Ready. Yes, it's Nebula the horse. Nebula the horse. That's what I'm going to call him. I got a reference photo I'm going off. And just one of those little books that I normally show during some of my paintings. Anyway, let's get some outlining done then. I need to get a small brush. I need to get a little detailing brush. I'm just going to go into a number a 4. And I'm going to go back into this blue-white mix. There we go, a little bit of blue. That's all we want. And let's just get the shape that we need in there like that. Use a little bit of liquid clear again because it keeps the paint open. Go down. Okay, we got the most of that blocked out. Let's go into a short flat now. Let's get some of this Prussian blue and black. Prussian blue and black. And let's block out this horse. We're going to call him Nebula. That's what we're going to call him. Get a bit of that white colour. Just get a bit of colour onto the side of his face there. Right? We're not going to see much detail, but we want to get a little bit of shape to this, if we can. Pick up this shape a bit more. There we are. It's a bit better. Bring his neck down. Let's put a bit of white across his flank there. Bring a bit of this colour black colour back in. Bit of black. Going to straight into some black now. Mixing all these colours together. Bit of blue. Let's work on his flank. Let's get a bit of let's get a bit of white there and down into his leg. Some black. darks back into some blue. Oops, not too much. Just want a shape. As a representation shape. I like my representation. I like that word. It's a nice word. Just darken that down a bit in there. Put a bit of that black through. Just merge these colours. You can do this with this liquid clear. It's fun stuff to use because you know that you can play with it for a bit before it starts to dry on you. Even in temperature like I've got today here in the studio, which is quite warm in fact. Just putting this, trying to get his hoof in there. Oof, 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 yes. Just get his hoof in. Play around with that. That doesn't look quite right, does it? So let's just bring that down. Get a bit of blue in there then. Let's merge that together a minute. Get a bit of this white. That's the trouble of this, it's all going to be shadows and working on this shape. Spend a little bit of time just trying to get this right, and we will get there. We will. Let's just put in his tail in. I don't know, is he looking? I don't know, he's there, I think. I don't paint many horses, so I'm quite happy if this is going to work out, and he looks like a horse, so I'd be quite happy with that. I'm not a horse painter. This is the actual painting I was going to do for the Jason Bowen, Brandon Schaefer and Larry Hamilton challenge. So if you want to look at those challenges, please press the iCards, and it should be in there, if I remember to put them in. Block this out. Let's get a little bit of white on the brush now. Let's bring a little bit of oh dear, that went a bit winky wonky. I'll blend that into there. Just mixing these colours on the brush and on the canvas. Just trying to get a little bit of colour in there. I don't want it all dark, dark black. That's his stomach area there. And his legs coming down there like that. Maybe a little bit of black. A bit more black. Down, oops. Make sure I got black on the brush. That's better. Down like that. just to give that a bit of a line, separate that line from there. Just put a little bit of definition in the cheek area, a little bit of black now. Let's blacken up this a touch. I hope that looks like a horse. Okay. Let's get some of this white liquid clear. This white blue. Mop in my brow, because it is quite warm in here. And this. His mane in. You spend time with this. This could be a really, really, really good painting if you spend time with it. I'm trying to rush it a little bit now because I know I'm running over my time slot that I put in my mind. There's no law saying how long particular videos have got to be, but I don't like running long videos. So there you go. A nice big bushy tail he's got, this one. He certainly have. I think it's just the way he's running, I think. And his tail is swishing in the wind, making all these movements. I can put a little bit of colour back on that now. As you know, as I said to you earlier, that we can always add a little bit of colour wash at a later stage. Let's just put a little bit of black in there, just to define a couple of little muscle groups, maybe, I don't know. Not too happy with his face. How does it look? It looks pretty good. I think you can see what I'm trying to accomplish. I hope you can. And let's just put a little bit more black down. Like I said, you've got a little bit more time. I'll put a drawing on my Facebook page, www.clive5art.co.uk, for you to have a little go at. And if you can improve on it, please do that and let me know. Show me in the Clive 5 Art family. Show me what you can do with time. And don't shy away from having a go. If you've never tried something like this before, then have a go. You could never know until you try. There's no such thing as failure. Failure is just a seed of success. There you go. Failure is just a seed of success. We all practice and we all have problems. And there's nobody that is perfect in everything they do, and nobody does everything right the first time. Sometimes it takes several attempts, in fact, to do what we need to do. Okay. I'm going to dry that off very quickly with a hairdryer. What I want to do now is get a brush. I'm going to get one of these. These are one of my foliage brushes, but you can use any type of brush if you wanted to. You can use a short flat or anything like that, but I just happen to use this one because I like it. I'm going to get some of my mixing white there. Again, I'm going to make some sort of wash. And I'm going to use my medium mix formula for this. I'm going to make it a little bit thicker this time. You can use titanium white, but don't use too much white. That's my only thing, I would say. Now he's going to be running into the water, so he's going to be stirring up some splashes, some mist. And then just get a little bit of painting. Just flick it like that. And if you flick it like that, get a couple of drops. I guess if there's a few splashes. There we are. Pull this down and across. Get a little bit of a stronger paint now and put some actual splashes in. So just going straight into the neat paint now, and this is why I'm using this foliage brush, just to get those splashes like that. There you go. What we can do then, soften that up before it dries, get some kitchen roll, make a little circle bit like that, and then just turn it and pull off the excess paint like that. And that just softens that down a bit. And then we can get our short flat again, and then just tighten up where we need to tighten up and darken up. How are we looking? There we go. Let's get a little bit of that blue colour now, a wash again over the white that we put in for the tail, making sure it's dry. Make sure it's dry. Don't try and do this when it's wet, otherwise you'll have a mess. Just to colour a little bit of that tail off like that. There you go, a little bit on the top, just to colour, not make it look so bright. And there's a little bit there I'm not happy with, so let's get my detailed brush, and I'm going to go into a little bit of this purpley black, and I'm just going to just hide his ear a little bit more by just taking away that white line there like that. There you go. Oops. Some highlights in the tail. Just go back over that colour that we just put in, just to lift a few highlights. Don't be mean on the paint. Make sure you brush load this brush. Make sure you get a nice pure colour. Just to put a few little highlights in like that. I think I'm going to call that one done today. So please like, comment and subscribe. Please share my videos. And if it's the first time you've ever done one of my videos or seen one of my videos, then please click the iCards but there. I'll should take you into the main channel. Oh, there's a little me down there with my thumb up like that. And I'm really hot and sweaty here today. So I'm just going to sign the bottom corner. So my name is Clive from clive5art.co.uk. Have a good day, a good week, a good month, a good year, because I don't know exactly when you're going to be watching this, as time is relative on YouTube. So until the next time, have a good day, and I will see you in the studio then. So thank you for washing away the toils of stress of everyday life here in Wales, and I will see you next time. Nice. And that's a wrap.
Hey, welcome, thanks for stopping by. It's time to learn with our friend Clive. So grab your brush, have a great time. And don't forget to click subscribe. Visit clive5art.co.uk.